Now let's talk about pulseless arrest and V-fib. Ventricular fibrillation, or V-fib, and pulseless ventricular tachycardia, otherwise known as V-tach, are lethal dysrhythmias that do not produce a pulse. V-fib is the most common initial dysrhythmia in cardiac arrest and will regress to asystole if it's not treated in a short amount of time. The treatment for V-fib is rapid defibrillation. Every minute that defibrillation is delayed, the chance of survival is reduced by 10%. The key steps to treating ventricular fibrillation are a rapid assessment to confirm cardiac arrest, starting CPR, applying the defibrillator, and delivering the first shock as soon as possible. High-quality CPR needs to be performed with as few interruptions as possible by giving cycles of compressions at a depth of 2 to 2.4 inches deep and at a rate of 100 to 120 per minute, followed by two good full rescue breaths that cause chest rise and fall. The compressor needs to be changed every 2 minutes to avoid fatigue, which leads to a lessening of the depth of compression and a lessening of the rate of compressions. After the initial shock, an IV or IO needs to be established in order to give medications and fluids. The first medication would be epinephrine, 1 milligram, 1 to 10,000 IV or IO push every 3 to 5 minutes. And after the initial dose of epinephrine, a second shock is given. You should then consider placing an advanced airway with capnography. Remember that once an advanced airway is in place, CPR compressions then become continuous, and the compressions are 100 to 120 compressions a minute with one breath given every 6 seconds. If the patient remains in persistent V-fib after the initial shock and epinephrine administration, the next medication to be given is amiodarone. Amiodarone is going to be given at 300 milligrams via rapid IV or IO push. A second dose of 150 milligrams of amiodarone may be repeated one time in 3 to 5 minutes. Successful treatment of V-fib continues with high-quality CPR, reassessing the patient's cardiac rhythm every 2 minutes, delivering a shock if V-fib is present, and giving medication as indicated.